Good morning, students. In today's class, we will continue with chapter 8, basic 256 statements. Okay? And in the last class, we have done print statement. And print statement with semicolon. And print statement with plus sign. And input statement. And some programs I have explained you with input statement. Now next statement is conditional control statements in basic 256. So open your book, page number 77. So what are conditional control statements in basic? So in our daily life, we come across various situations where we have to take decisions based on some conditions. So let us take a real life example. It is rainy season. If you want to go out to play with your friends, so before you go, you need to be sure that the weather will remain clear throughout the day. So there is some conditions, and regarding this condition, we will make some plans for of actions and we will take some decisions. So if the weather is clear, so we will go out and play with your friends. If it is raining, so you will sit at home, enjoy watching television or probably read a story book. So with the condition, we will make the decision. Okay. So we can change our decision with some changing conditions. So similarly, programming in the computer language includes logics and decision making. So to put a check in any problem in programming, condition is to be applied. So it allows the program to select an action based on the user's input. So this condition executes the statements depending on the result of comparisons and controls the flow of a program. Now there is one quick quiz. What happens when we use semicolon with print statements? With this, we can give the next line output in the same line. Now, next is comparison operator. So, which comparison operators we will use in conditional control statements? So, previously we have discussed the basic arithmetic operators. Like, now let us look at the same, some additional operators. Like, less than, greater than, less than or equal to, greater than or equal to, is equal to, and this is not equal to. This sign is for not, okay, not equal to. So these are some additional operators which are using for comparison between two values. Okay, so we often need to compare two values in a program that help us to decide what to do. So, a comparison operators work with two values and return true, one. Okay, we will write one for true and zero for false. So, it is based on the result of the comparison. So, the comparison operators are also known as relational operators. So, some relational operators, I will explain you with some examples. So one example you can see, this is the operator equal to operator. Okay, so explanation to check whether two values are equals to each other or not. Where, okay, when we will use this operator, when we want to check the whether two values are equal or not. So you can see one example, A equals to B. So we will check the value of A and B, they are equal or not. So suppose value of A is 8 and value of B is 4. So what will be the result of this example? It will be false, because A and B is not equal. So 8 equals to 4, it is, answer will be false. Now this, what will be the next? This is to check whether two values are not equal to each other. This is the opposite of this equal to operator. This is the not equal to sign. Okay. With this operator, we will check two values are not equal to each other. Like example, A not equal to B, we will write like this. So, 8 is not equal to 4, this is true. So, what will be the result? True. Now, next operator is greater than. So, to check whether the first value is greater than the second value, we will write like this, A greater than B, answer will be true because 8 is greater than 4. This is the less than operator. So, it is used to check whether the first value is less than the second value, A less than B, answer will be false. Okay. So, 8 less than 4, it is false because 8 is bigger than B. Now, next operator is greater than equal to. So, to check whether the first value is greater than or as well as equal to the second value. Okay. Only greater than operator will check the greater value, but a greater equal will check if value will not greater but it can be equal. So both the condition will true, then the answer will be, result will be true. So A greater than equals to B. So what will the result? Value of it is A is 8. So 8 greater than B, yes it is true. Now next, less than equal to, check whether the first value is less than or equal to the second value. A less than equals to B, answer will be false. So I hope you will understand all the relational operators and comparison operators. Now there is another quick quiz. If A equals to 20, B equals to 15, then what will be the result of A not equal to B? So think about it. Now next, after that, comparison operators. There are some predefined conditional control statements in Basic 256. So now we will make some programs with these statements. First is if then statement. So the if then statement is the most basic type of control statement. It is used for making decisions based on comparisons. Comparisons are made with the help of relational operators. I have explained you all the relational operators. So we will use these operators in with if then statement. So if the condition evaluates to true, then the block of statement specified after then and if are executed. If the condition is false, then these statements are not executed and the control directly shift to the next statement after and if. Now what will be the syntax of if then? If after that we will write the condition, after write we will write that, then we will write a statement. So what will be the, if the condition, this condition will be true, then the next statement will be executed, and this is for then. Next, false statement, after that we will write in the end of a program, end if. So this is the syntax for if then statement. So I will explain you with one example. You can see if x greater than y, okay, why, when this statement or condition will be true, after that, after then statement will be executed. Statement will be right after then is executed. Now C is equal to C plus 1. Now it, after that end if, it means that if x is greater than y, then 1 is added to the value of C. Okay, this statement will be executed when this statement will be true. If C greater than 10, okay, then print C. So, the value of C will be printed only if the value of C is greater than 10. Now, there is another, let's know more, if then statement, also known as decision making statement. Now that know the fact, instructions are given to the form of statement. These statements are used to write a program to perform different tasks. Now, next program 7, I will explain you. This is a program to compare your age with your friends. Friends' age, okay? So first we'll write SELS, then input, how old are you? This message will be displayed. Now you have to enter your age. Now input, how old is your friend? Now after that, you have to input your friend's age. Now print, you are. If your age less than your friend age, okay? Now your age is less than if your friend's age, then what will be the message? What message will print? It will print younger than. After that, if your age equals to your friend age, then it will print the same age as. And if your age greater than your friend's age, then it will print the message older than. Okay, after that, print your friend. If and if. So we have to write for every if then. There is one and if for every if then. So we have used in this program more than one if. So we have written three if. Okay, if then and if then. So three if we have used. So we have to end three if in the end. So for this we have to write three times and if, and if, and if, and if. Okay. So what will be the output? First it will ask, how old are you? So suppose we have written 14. This is your age. And how old is your friend? Friend's age is 15. Now you are younger than your friend. Okay. So it is which condition will be true? Yes, this is. So your age is less than to your friend's age. So what message will be will print? You are younger than your friend. Okay. Now next program. Program number 8. So okay. First, let us recall point. The values of variable are assigned according to their type, numeric or string. Now, program number 8 is program to compare two numbers and display the result with the proper message. It will compare two numbers. Now, CLS, input, enter first number. Okay, we have to enter first number in N1. After that, enter second number. After that, we have to enter second number in N2. So condition we will write like this: n1 greater than n2, then print greater number is n1, and n1 less than n2, then print greater number is n2. And if n1 equals to n2, then it will print both the numbers are equal. So end if, and then end. So what will be the output? If suppose we have entered first number 1, second number is 4. So what message will be print? So greater number is 4. Okay. Now there is another quick quiz. Which command helps to insert comments that enable us to understand what the program is all about? We are using hash sign for this. So which statement waits for the user response? It is input statement. So now next program, program number 9, program to display whether a person is eligible to vote or not. Okay, so CLS, input, enter your age. We have to enter our age variable we have taken for this. So our age greater than 18, it will print you are eligible to vote. And if your age less than 18, then it will print you are not eligible to vote. Now end if. So what will be the output? Enter your age 20, you are eligible to vote. Now program number 10 is program to print the square of a number if the number is not equal to 0. Okay, so CLS, input, enter any number, numb,